The project at Babes Beach is a continuation of several projects that we've seen over the last 6 years. And this is a nourishment project where we're taking sand from the Galveston ship channel that's being dredged, and it's being placed here on the beach behind me. The original projects that we had took the beach about 1.2 miles, and with this latest project, we've been able to extend the length of the beach an additional half mile. Actually, several years ago, there was no beachfront here at all. What we had was just some rocks, and the water would come right up against the wall. A lot of people know us from the 1900 storm that devastated Galveston Island before the seawall itself was constructed and before we had these wide beaches.
My ancestor was killed in the Galveston hurricane in 1900. My great-great-grandmother went to Galveston to shop for school. Is what I was told, and then she never came home. My family was involved with trying to get the original seawall built there years ago. The idea of Galveston being resilient is very important to, you know, I think me personally, just from the history of my family.
We learned a lot from the 1900 storm. We learned that not only is Galveston capable of coming back bigger and stronger, but there are certain things that we can do to protect our island for the future. We saw that during Hurricane Ike in 2008. Having some reinforced beaches here in Galveston was really beneficial to protecting our island economy and allowing us to bounce back.
The Beach Nourishment Project in Galveston received just over $9 million in Restore Act funding for the project. And so being able to rebuild the beach down there with dredge material is going to do a number of things. The first is obviously it's going to make the area more resilient to the next storm. But the added benefit is that the public's going to get to use that beach for the foreseeable future.
The Restore project came along at a great time for us. We hadn't been able to identify additional funding beyond what we'd already gotten with the first two cycles, and so the timing of this is quite significant.
Beach projects are difficult to fund. We started working with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers in 2016 to define the plan, reached out to our state partners, the Texas General Land Office, secured the commitment of the city of Galveston, and then reached for the restore funding to put the final bow on it. All of that took about 5 years, which in municipal project timelines was very efficient.
Whenever we do a dredge cycle and we place sand onto our beaches, we're reinforcing the island against any kind of catastrophic damage from storms. This is going to be beneficial not only for the island itself and its ecosystem, but it's also going to help our residents. Having that depth of beach provides a buffer, if you will, if a storm's coming in before it hits the seawall and maybe crests over the seawall. In addition to that, whenever we lay sand where it's not been before, we're increasing the value of the homes and the properties that sit in front of that beach.
I'm so proud of the proactive nature that the city of Galveston has taken in addressing our beaches and the nourishment of our beaches. For so many years, we had erosion problems here and we fought that, but with the nourishment projects and partnering with the Army Corps of Engineers with this beneficial dredging, we now have a proactive stance and a proactive plan to move forward for the future.